Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of a CDN, guys. That is a nothing but content delivery network. Okay, so I think this topic is already covered in some subject. I don't know exactly which subject. Anyway, I'll be adding that video before this video. Obviously, if you are watching in the playlist, you have seen that video, right? Yes. Okay, so anyway, let me revise it once again. So basically, what is this content delivery network? So what is its use? Why we need it? So we'll be discussing about that introduction here. Okay, yes. So basically, assume that you are running a website, guys. Okay, so even if you want, I can give my website example also. Okay, yes. So my website data is stored in India in one place, that is in Mumbai it is stored. Okay, yes. And the second server or second data is stored in Singapore, guys. Okay, yes. So for that I am using a CDN called as Cloudflare. Okay, yes. So it is a free service, you can say. So basically it is a free service. Okay, yes. So they will take your server's data. Okay, so my host provider is from Bangalore or Mumbai, so that is the reason why his data is stored there. And with Cloudflare, I'll be creating a virtual copy of that in Singapore also. Okay, so you might be saying that, okay, so what am I trying to say? So basically, whenever you are storing your data at multiple places, okay, so here you are, what you are sharing, guys, this is nothing but your content, right? Yes. And whenever a request comes, so based on its distance, so basically if this is closer or this is closer or this is closer, so based on that distance, if it is deciding where to get the data, and if the delivery of that is really fast, so this concept is nothing but content delivery network, guys. So this network, right, I tried to draw some network, right, of four places. So that is nothing but your content delivery network. Okay, so even this will reduce your time, guys. So basically assume that my server is only in Bangalore. So if someone from Singapore wants it, so now if it is replicated, he can directly get it from Singapore. Else his request will come to India, and in India it will come to Bangalore or Mumbai. So then he will his request will be fulfilled and he will get his data, and it's a time taking process. So basically by using CDNs, we are going to reduce the time, guys, right? Yes. So a CDN or content delivery network is a highly distributed platform for servers that helps minimize delay in load web pages content during reducing the physical distances. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got the basic idea, right? So what I explained in my own words is written in English here, there, right? Simple, right? Yes. So this helps user around the world view, okay, the same high quality content without slowing down. So basically if you replicated your data at hundreds of servers all over the world, so at that time, your data will be within seconds, it will load, right? Yes, that is the power of CDN, guys. And it will not cost you that much you think, guys. It's really a cheap service, you can say. And it's an efficient way, okay? Yes. So these are CDN providers, a detailed analysis, caching facilities and everything. So basically, whenever I log in into my dashboard, it will say how much GB of things are cached, how much data is cached, how many downloads have been done, how much data has been transferred from my website. Everything will be written, guys. It's really a wonderful place to learn about your website. So it's an analytical tool also, you can say. Even it will say how many visitors came. Okay, yes. So that is all about CDN, guys. Okay, yes. So now let us go through some advantages and then let us move on to disadvantages also. Yes, okay. So your reliability and response time gets a huge boost. So basically, if your data is replicated at multiple servers, obviously if one server is down, some other server will respond. What's there in that, right? Yes. Hence, your data is 100% reliable and the response time is fast. So basically, if you are near to the server now, you can directly get the data at really high rate, right? Yes. So high performance websites, equally high convention and growth sales. Okay. Latency and speed issues tend to creep a website. So basically, that will be resolved. Okay. Yes. You got an idea, right? So what the point is trying to say. Okay. Similarly, CDN enables global reach. So basically from anywhere around the world, you can access it. So it will take some time for you, but to adjust for the CDN and all those things, but it's really easy, guys. If your website is once adopted for it, it's really a piece of cake for you from the next time. Okay. Yes. So CDN saves a lot of money instead of buying server space. So basically instead of buying server places at multiple places, using this concept of CDN, you can directly deploy your data or you make a copy of your data at any place you want. Got it? Yes. Similarly, 100% availability. So basically, even if one server is down, the other server will help you, right? Similarly, reducing the server loads. So as now we are having multiple servers or multiple storage spots, so the traffic will be divided, right? If you are using load balancer, it will be divided. If it is just based on distance, it will be somewhat less, right?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, we will be having 24/7 customer support. So whenever you face any issues while configuration, while any kind of security issues, you can just inform them and they will be right back to you at any moment of time. Okay. Yes. Similarly, it provides a DOS attack. So basically, even in that analytics, it will also say from which places someone tried to log in with your credentials. So those kind of things, tools are also in it. Okay. Analysis can also be done. So these are some advantages, you can say. Okay. So now let us move through some disadvantages, guys. So till now I told many advantages, right? So you might be thinking that, okay, so that's the best service, right? Yes, it's a best service, but there are some disadvantages, you can say. So basically, if you want to replicate your server at multiple places, so I did it for two places as it is a free plan. Right, I don't want to pay any kind of money, so that's the reason why I just adopted for free plan, right?
Yes.
So if you are a serious person and you want your website to load really fast and you want everything in a proper way, it is a paid service, you can say, guys. So you need to pay some amount every month. It's not a one-time payment, so it should be paid every month. Okay. So adds a complexity for large problems and could cause high loading times. So basically, whenever you initially, if you start building your website with the CDN, it's absolutely a great thing, guys. But if you have your website 100% established, and now if you want to add CDN, it's a bit complex task, guys. Because some kind of files like JavaScript files or HTML files could get corrupted, and there will be multiple issues, guys, sometimes with some cloud providers. So that is the reason why it's not recommended, and it's a bit complex also. That's also you should remember. And most of these CDNs will inform you to back up your website before you proceed the steps also. So it's always a good thing on CDNs. Okay. Yes. Similarly, global availability may lead to not available at some small places. So assume that you planned to make your website available worldwide, but it ended up being an issue. So basically, you maintain some servers in US and everywhere, but there are no traffic there. So there is no request at all. So what is the use? So instead of that, you can buy some servers in your local area where the traffic is high and you can use them. Right, so that could be also a disadvantage if you are taking in a wrong way, that you should remember. Okay, yes. So these are some of you popular, you can say, guys, popular CDNs. Cloudflare, which I use, that's the reason why I wrote it first. StackPath, SecuriKey, Key CDN, Google Cloud CDN, Amazon Cloudflow, Azure CDN. So basically, this is from Google, this is from Amazon, and this is from Microsoft, guys. Okay,
yes.
So I hope everyone got a clear idea about CDN advantages, disadvantages, and few popular ones. Okay,
yes.
So in the next lecture, we'll be discussing about cloud security, guys. Okay,
yes.
So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.